This is Liberia.
This song that was made here when we were kids, you know, coming up, that Michael went to change his skin, he hated being black, regretted why God made him black, and all of that, and so he wanted to be white.
And that was a song in Africa, yeah?
Yeah, and the song was, Michael Jackson was a black man, he wants to turn to white man, can make all we kill him, can make all we kill him.
Oh my God.
And how do you become a star of them?
True story of Michael Jackson.
Yes.
Yeah. So you see, the media is so bad, and they just always like to write and say things far from the truth.
He didn't want to change it. He had no choice. You know, he suffered from a disease. And in his disease, when Michael took off his clothes, he was half black and half white. His legs were half black and half white. His own body attacked him, and it depigmented his skin. Sometimes you'll see it in Africa, children that have big patches of white on their skin. Michael suffered from that condition, so we had to use some chemicals to make him the wrong color.
In some of the magazines around here, that in fact, some people, some magazines quoted him as saying that he regretted the day God made him black man. I love that. Wish like God the black people, a lot of Africans too angry.
Yes, of course.
He didn't like the color, yeah. So it's just today, after all these years, today I'm just getting the truth straight.
One skin was black and one was white.
And so you can just imagine how long we've lived with lies.
He went into one of the rooms and he was reading a book on dermatology.
Okay.
And there was a picture of a black African child, about seven, with vitiligo, you know, sort of where the child was with two different colors in the skin, you know?
Yeah.
And Michael, you know, turned around to me and says, nobody knows the pain that that child is suffering, you know? Mm. And that was even before he told me what was wrong with himself. So there's a nice African sun now, isn't it? Under African skies.
His path was marked by the stars in the southern hemisphere, and he walked his days under African skies.